had the amazing opportunity to take solar performance data during a total solar eclipse. My house was in the path of totality for the 2024 solar eclipse, and contrary to most days in Ohio, it was actually mostly sunny. There was just a little bit of wispy clouds that came throughout the day. Welcome back to Projects with Everyday Dave. Let's dig into some once-in-a-lifetime solar eclipse data. I collected as much data as I could. I took a time lapse of the main array so that you can see the cloud cover in the sky, the change in darkness as the solar eclipse comes through, and the shadows on the ground as they shift throughout the time period. I cut up a pair of solar eclipse glasses and taped them over the lens on my GoPro so I could point it directly at the sun and take a time lapse of the sun as the moon comes across it. Then I coordinated that with all of my other data so that we can watch the phases as the data changes. I recorded the real-time output of my Victron system connected to my wood rack array, and I also tracked the output from the main array on my solar edge system. We had some friends and family over to watch the eclipse, and it was a lot of fun, although they did make fun of me for sitting there taking data while everyone was watching. But I took the data because I knew you would appreciate it, and you can help me out by hitting the like button so I can prove to them that I'm not the only one interested in that kind of data. Really, just this once, if you could hit the like button so that I can show them all the people that liked this information. Okay, I synchronized all of the data and accelerated the time scale to watch it run all at the same time. I put the animated image from time.com in the corner for reference. Unfortunately, the SolarEdge monitor averages this data over a 15-minute period, so we won't get to see it go all the way down to zero in this graph, but we'll be able to see that in a minute with the Emporia view and Victron datasets. As we approach totality, I'm slowing down the time lapse a little bit so you can see that moment more clearly. It's like a vast shadow that just engulfs everything, and then just as quickly, it's gone. The sun's power gradually comes back, and the array's power comes back to match. Although it doesn't come back quite as high as before, and that's because the sun is less perpendicular to the panels at this point in the day. Unfortunately, I lost the last few minutes of my time lapse of the eclipse because the sun went behind the roof of the house. Let's zoom in for just a minute on the array time lapse. I had not experienced totality before, and let me tell you, it's an experience to remember. First, you can see what appears to be a storm approaching on the horizon, but it's just the shadow coming towards the array. Also, notice how there's a distinct shadow on the ground as long as there is any sunlight at all. Then, suddenly, it just goes completely dark as the shadow passes completely overhead. The frogs and crickets start their evening symphony, and the air was noticeably cooler. A friend of mine took this picture at totality. I believe the pink spots are solar flares shooting past the edge of the moon. Then, almost as quickly as it began, the horizon began to brighten like the morning dawn. And then, boom, the first prick of light around the edge of the moon, and the shadows come back and everything lights up like it's day again. Although everything lights up as soon as the first prick of light is available around the moon, it doesn't start feeling warm to the skin until about a third of the sun is exposed. Fortunately, I have an Emporia View monitoring system on my solar combiner box, so I can get up-to-the-minute resolution with that data. This graph shows the solar edge output from the main array in blue, and that includes the vertical panels. The orange part of the graph is the rest of the main array, which is running off my SunGold inverter, and it's capturing a top row of bifacial panels and a bottom row of standard panels at the end of the array. Then the little bit of green at the top is the shed array, which is running microinverters. Zooming in on the data, I can see all the systems went to zero at about 309. Even though it looks like there's a little bit of production there, it's just noise in the data. Actually, all the systems are completely shut off. That's only 8 minutes of downtime, and some of that is the systems booting back up once the sun comes around the edge of the moon. Basically, if there is any sun peeking past the moon at all, the system is producing power. The Emporia View has become my favorite system for monitoring both production and consumption loads throughout my house. I'll put a link in the description below for the one I use in case you want to check them out. Before I jump to the Victron system result, I thought it would be fun to plot the bifacial vertical array against the main array during the eclipse to see what that looks like. Let's look at a typical graph first to refresh your memory in case you didn't watch my video on vertical bifacial panel performance. Here you can see on a typical sunny day, the vertical panels outperform in the morning and in the evening, but there's a significant dip at midday, and that's because the sun is hitting the edge of the panels and very little light is hitting the face of the panels themselves. There's a couple of interesting things to note. First, because this data is an average over 15 minutes, It appears that there's some power production at totality, but we know from the Emporia output that there's actually no power from any of the systems being produced right at that moment. The really interesting thing about this is the main array takes a much bigger hit because the vertical array normally doesn't produce very much power midday, and that's when the eclipse occurred. The south-facing array outperforms for the first half of the day, but from the eclipse on, the vertical array wins the day. If you look at the whole day's production, the vertical panels perform better than usual on a sunny day, hitting 82% of the south-facing bifacial panels output instead of the typical 74% I would see on a sunny day. However, that's nothing to get too excited about since we don't see solar eclipses very often. It's not going to have a significant impact on the comparison between the vertical array and the south-facing array. Finally, we can look at the most precise time data from the Victron off-grid system, since I recorded that continuously throughout the actual event. That system is powered by my firewood rack solar array that I made from mostly recycled materials. You can see it drops all the way down to 5 watts before it goes to zero at 3:08. Then at 3:15, it starts back up, starting at 5 watts, and continues up from there. That's only 7 minutes of downtime, and some of that is the system powering back up. That's one of the things I like about the Victron system. I mean, it takes every little bit of available energy. To power that thing from 5 watts is pretty amazing. But what we can see from all of this data is all the systems maintained output within a couple of minutes of totality. It's almost like a light switch. You either have power or you don't. Even the smallest prick of sunlight coming around the moon is enough to generate power. That's pretty neat. It was fun to see God's power on display, turning the sun, our biggest free power supply, into a celestial animated work of art. If you didn't see my vertical versus bifacial analysis, you can watch it or one of my other solar projects right here. You can also find lots of solar projects, discounts, and educational resources on my website for free, projectswithdave.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.